Welcome to Psychic Talk USA.
Have you given any ideas to going into business for yourself?
Yes, how did you know that? Yes.
She's a psychic.
Is there someone from your past that you're still thinking about?
Yes, someone in the past. I'm shocked. No, really, because, I mean, I didn't think you guys could see all that.
They saw, honey, deep into your closet.
Uh-oh. He's dependable. He's all those things all those other guys you had weren't. Go get him. This would be a good one for you.
This is great. I'm so glad that I called. I feel so much better.
We're going to give each and every one of you who calls this number 10 whole minutes of one of the best psychics anywhere. This one's free, folks. So write this number down and just do it.
Does she have children?
One daughter.
A gorgeous little girl.
Now, is she modeling or you? Because I keep feeling there's a modeling.
Oh, you are so good.
Call in now. You won't be put on hold or get a busy signal. Everyone will get to talk to their psychic for a full 10 minutes. This one's free, so don't miss it. Dial right now.
Call 1-800-407-7467.
The smashing pumpkin rings.
Things started. I mean, what we usually hear about Chicago is the blues scene. Yeah.
Well, there's been the music scene in Chicago was really dead about 5 or 6 years ago, and usually when it's dead, then bands start to want to do something. So now you have, you know, Urge Overkill, Jesus Lizard, and
we have all the Wax Trax kind of dance stuff. That's very big too.
But it's not a thriving music scene at all.
Does it feel like Chicago has a strong alternative scene, and it's getting stronger?
Yeah, I think its strength is in its diversity, and in a strange way, that's what people say about Chicago. That's what makes Chicago a great city is the diversity involved, and the bands. I mean, they're all different, and it's nice to see other people having success, but people have tried to pin it down into some kind of musical scene, and it's just really not.
Did you have an idea in mind musically when you started, what you wanted to do and what you didn't want to do?
More so like a theoretical idea than like a musical idea. Like I wanted to be open so that we could play whatever kind of music we wanted to play, so it wasn't like just rock or just whatever. It's okay to play different types of music, but you don't have to be just a rock band, you know? I mean, the great bands like Jefferson Airplane or Led Zeppelin, I mean, they played all styles of music, and that's how we want to be. Because that way the band can grow and change, and doesn't, if you decide you don't want to be, 100% rock band, you're not stuck. You don't have to break up the band and go form another band just to play another style of music.
But did it come naturally to have that particular sound, that particular Smashing Pumpkin sound? Or did you have to work on it, really, and do you have to stop sometimes and say, oh, we're going too far now?
Well, we went through a lot of, you know, different types of phases where our set kind of reflected different types of rock or different types of tangents we're on, but yeah, after a while we honed it down to what's on the album.
I mean, if you start with this, you know, okay, let's play any type of music you want to play, I mean, it's going to take you a while to kind of go. It took a while, but I mean, it was natural in the sense that every time we'd start to go down a road that we were uncomfortable with, we'd know that it was wrong.
Is it easier now for an alternative band to make it in the States?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely. The record companies, the major record companies are looking for that now, paying the big bucks, you know, for those types of bands.
They're looking for alternative bands that will sell well and also give them credibility, basically.
You're good for record companies.
Yeah, I guess
we're, I don't think they really care about the credibility. They never cared about that before, but sell them records. Yeah,
money.
Definitely.
Thank you. see as the trends for the future where music is concerned?
Hopefully music of the 90s will be a little bit more honest than it was in the previous two decades. I mean, you know, 80s music and even 70s music was very trend oriented.
Right.
Hopefully the 90s music will be a little bit more reflective of individual personality as opposed to what people are wearing, you know. I mean, that's what I'd like to see anyway.
Yeah.
I mean, that's kind of what we're about.
Is there any statement behind your lyrics?
We don't have any political statements.
The statement is individualistic. It's think for yourself and be yourself. If anything, if anybody wants to draw anything, that's what I would draw from it.